I strongly believe in Bridging the Gap initiative, because I can see that what has happened here at Harpeth Community Church within me, it has radically transformed my life. And I really believe in the mission of this church of making biblical disciples.
About 2.5 years ago, my husband and I went through an extremely difficult time as a family. Our oldest daughter was born with multiple challenges, and she passed away at 4 days old. During that period of time, I experienced what one might consider a crisis of faith. I was having to start over in everything that I believed and thought that I knew and understood about Jesus. And I had a lot of questions.
It's important this day and age that we don't just let people do whatever they want to and say it's okay, you know, we'll turn our head the other way. I think once people make the commitment to follow Christ, they need to follow Christ, and I think it's in the Bible that the church is supposed to hold them accountable, and I think Harpeth is one of the few churches that continue to do that on a consistent basis. So.
This has ignited within me a passion to reach the lost and hurting world, and I feel that this is a logical next step towards that goal.
Our home group meets weekly. We have the specific lessons that we discuss and talk about, but it's so much more than that. We've met together for meals. We've had baptisms in our home group. We've had baby showers. We've had really tough times where we've just had to rally around one another and pray for each other. And we've had times where we can just hang out and just be together. So it's so much more than just a specific structure. It's just being able to sit down and do life and walk this journey along with each other.
Bobby made himself very accessible to me. I would have panic and a lot of anxiety over certain truths, and I would call and email Bobby pretty much, you know, every other day for a while, trying to figure out what I believed, why I believed it, and he was there for me. And for the lead pastor to take the time out to meet someone's individual needs is just unheard of. I don't know many churches that have that kind of access to their pastor. And he and my community group walked us through a valley.
Every time I leave this church at Harpeth and I feel like a tiny bit of hope that everything's going to be okay and God has got me, and I really want people to feel that too.
I see in the future this initiative reaching more of the community. I see our Celebrate Recovery program expanding exponentially, where more people can come with their hurts, habits, and hang-ups, where people can take off their masks, where people can be free and find freedom in Jesus.
I think Bridging the Gap is going to open so many doors for us. Right now we're limited in our resources. We're worshiping in an office building that wasn't designed to be a worship center. We have so many different things trying to share the same space, and sometimes juggling all those schedules can be a lot.
I call Harpeth home because I'm committed to be a person of discipleship, to make people feel welcome, to make people feel loved, because I remember when I didn't feel welcome or loved. But someone out there welcomed and loved me with open arms. So I want to be that person that does that. I want to help hopeless people who don't feel like they can connect anywhere. And I want to be the person that bridges that gap.
Not only that, not only Bobby, but like I said, the group rallied around us week after week. They let me voice my sadness, my anger, my frustration. They loved me unconditionally. And they actually planted a tree for our daughter in her honor on the church property. to remember her life, and it was the most generous, kind, thoughtful act that anyone has ever done for us. And we believe, truly believe, that we made it through that dark time in our lives because of the support and the encouragement of Harpeth Church and our church family.
God wants to do so much in our community. I know that He wants to move in a mighty way in Franklin and in Tennessee, and that's going to come through having the resources and the space to bring in different opportunities, to bring in different ways to serve our community and to help others grow deeper in their spiritual walk with Christ.